Hi, I'm Emma, Environmental Specialist at Ecochain, and I'm going to explain to you the concept of the functional units. This is a super important concept at LCA because it determines per what unit you're calculating the outcomes of your LCA. And for this reason, it's very important to think about what you're going to pick as a functional unit and why. So determining the functional unit is part of the goal and scope phase, the first phase of your LCA. So in this phase, you determine what the goal of your LCA is, so what you want to achieve, and also how you want to achieve this goal. And this is kind of like a plan of action for your LCA. And determining the functional unit is a part of this goal and scope phase, or part of this action plan. So what is a functional unit actually? Well, a functional unit is the unit with which you measure your product or service or function that you're trying to assess in your life cycle assessment. This can be a lot of different things. For example, if I want to do an LCA about a dishwashing machine, I can, for example, do an LCA for one product, so for one dishwashing machine, and calculate the impact of this. But I can also, for example, calculate the impact of one cycle of using the dishwashing machine. Or perhaps I want to know the impact of washing 20 dishes. And then I could, for example, take washing 20 dishes with the dishwashing machine as a functional unit. Or maybe I want to calculate it for a certain time unit, a time frame. So I can say I want to know what the impact of using the dishwasher machine for 20 minutes is. Well, you can imagine how big the possibilities are. One thing that's really important in narrowing these down and picking your functional unit is the goal that you have for your LCA. There are a few things that you want to keep in mind while determining your functional unit. And the first one is, for example, comparability. So you're likely to want to compare your product with other products in the market. And then it's really important that you are using the same functional unit as these other products or these benchmarking databases, because otherwise you can never compare your LCA outcomes, because you of course have to measure it for the same functional unit. You can only compare apples with apples, otherwise you're going to have a very unfair comparison. And the second thing is that you might want to think about how your functional unit would be scalable. So for example, if I am baking cakes and I want to know the impact of this apple pie I'm baking, but I also want to know the impact of the strawberry pie I'm baking, and I also want to be able to compare them, it might be very handy to take my functional unit in kilograms, so that I can compare 1 kilogram of apple pie and 1 kilogram of strawberry pie, for example. But I can also easily convert this to the impact of one full pie by scaling it. And in this way, I can achieve different goals with my LCA. So this is also something you want to think about. And a third thing that you might want to think about is how you have your data available. So if you have your data available per kilogram, for example, it might be very handy to pick a functional unit that you can easily convert from this kilogram basis to something else. So in this video, I explained the concept of the functional unit to you, and I also told you how to determine your functional unit. So good luck in doing so. If you have any more questions or difficulties with this, check out our website or get in touch with us. Thank you for watching this video.